It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project scenario, your company has a successful multiplayer game that has become popular in the US. Now it wants to expand to other regions. It is launching a new feature that allows users to trade points. This feature will work for users across the globe. Your company's current MySQL backend is reaching the limit of the computing engine instance that hosts the game. Your company wants to migrate to a different database that will provide global consistency and high availability across the regions. Which database should they choose? In this very good situation for your company, you already have a product that is successful. A new feature being launched is expected to have a large increase in traffic. You've got users all across the globe. However, your current infrastructure is not catching up. It is currently hosted on Compute Engine instances and it has got a single MySQL backend. We ideally want to migrate to a better database that provides high availability across regions, but is also globally consistent. What are our options? How about BigQuery? BigQuery supports SQL, and therefore, given that the original data was in MySQL, it might be easy to migrate to BigQuery. So we're good for that. However, BigQuery is a regional or multi-region solution in EU and US and is not truly global. Of course, you can access it from anywhere, but then you're going to have increased latency. Also, BigQuery is optimized for reads and for large-scale analytics. It is not suitable for writes and the kind of requirement that we have in this project. Therefore, we have to eliminate BigQuery as an option. How about Cloud SQL? Given that the current database is MySQL and that Cloud SQL is just managed SQL databases like MySQL, Postgres, or MSSQL, this becomes a good option to start with. So, where we were managing our own MySQL, since it is now managed for us, operations becomes much easier. Therefore, that's definitely a win. However, we will have all the technical limitations of MySQL, which is that it tends to be regional and not truly global. If we serve all of it from one place, then we are going to have latency issues, since all our users are going to be spread across the world. Based on that, we will eliminate option B because Cloud SQL just does not scale for our requirement. How about Cloud Spanner? The technology for Cloud Spanner allows it to have global availability. Of course, it also supports SQL, so that's a win. It is global and highly available, and that is also a win. Interestingly, even though it's a global database, it still provides consistency, which allows for transactions. And therefore, we've got three thumbs up on Cloud Spanner, and therefore this seems to be the best option we have so far. In the actual exam, I wouldn't immediately go click C and then move on. Instead, I will park the answer and see if there's an even better option. So, Cloud Spanner looks a very good option, but let's still check out option D, which is Cloud Bigtable. Cloud Bigtable is a NoSQL database. But if you look at the requirement, there is nothing that says the database that we migrate to has to be SQL. So this is a perfectly legitimate option to have a NoSQL database. Bigtable also scales globally. you can have clusters replicated in other regions, and therefore we will have global availability with Bigtable. Bigtable also scales very well for reads and writes. As long as we keep adding nodes, it is able to scale linearly. Therefore, we still have got three thumbs up even on Bigtable, and this seems to be a reasonable option so far. However, Bigtable is not a database that provides consistency. It's a database that provides eventual consistency, but it cannot be used for transactions for the very same reason. Therefore, just on the factor of global consistency, we are going to have to drop Cloud Bigtable as an option. We also discussed that the current database is MySQL, and Bigtable being NoSQL did not immediately match, but that was not part of the requirement. In the actual exam, take care of things like this. Don't assume a requirement that is not specified. Of course, it would be good to have a SQL to SQL transition, but if it is not part of the requirement, it becomes an open consideration at that point. Even so, just based on global consistency, we are going to have to eliminate Bigtable as an option, which leaves us with only Cloud Spanner as the best option for this requirement. If you thought that content was great, you absolutely must check out all our new upcoming content. So subscribe right away.